Mr. Sadiq Khan, see the situation of TFL.
A video is circulating on social media showing a crowd of mostly Indian immigrants rushing onto a bus in Ruislip, London, while two middle-aged British women look baffled. The scene resembles a bustling bus ride in Mumbai or Delhi, a stark contrast to the usual calm of London. Immigration is a hot topic today, with people moving for better job opportunities, education, safety, or an improved quality of life. But how does this affect the societies they join and leave behind? Let's start with the numbers. According to the International Organization for Migration, there were over 281 million international migrants in 2020, making up 3.6% of the global population. That's nearly one in every 30 people. The UK, the US, Germany, Saudi Arabia, France, Canada, and Australia have become top destinations for migrants, including a significant number from India. According to the UK's Office for National Statistics, as of 2021, around 370,000 Indian nationals reside in the UK, and 1.9 million people in England and Wales identify as Indian, making up 3.1% of the population. This makes them one of the largest immigrant groups. Bureau of Immigration data shows that 7.65 lakh Indian nationals went abroad for studies by October 2023. India has one of the largest diasporas globally, with over 17.5 million Indians living abroad. That's more than the entire population of some countries. In recent years, India has been the leading source of migration to OECD countries, a group of 38 high-income nations with a high Human Development Index, including the United States, Canada, the United Kingdom, and many European nations. These immigrants contribute significantly to their host countries' economies and cultural landscape. For example, Indian professionals play crucial roles in the UK's National Health Service and the tech industry. In the USA, Indian IT professionals fill key roles and start influential companies in Silicon Valley. In Australia, Indians contribute significantly to healthcare, education, and IT. In Canada, Indians became the top source of new permanent residents in 2021, greatly impacting the tech industry and other high-demand sectors. However, immigration also brings challenges like overcrowding and strain on public services, as seen in the video, leading to tensions and competition for resources. This fuels narratives that immigrants are taking over. Common concerns include job competition, cultural integration, and social cohesion, shifting attitudes towards immigrants, and increasing resentment. For example, while the UK's NHS benefits from Indian doctors and nurses, it also faces pressure from a growing population, resulting in longer wait times and resource shortages. A 2023 survey by Ipsos and British Future shows public dissatisfaction with the UK government's handling of immigration at its highest since 2015, with 66% dissatisfied. In the US, a Pew Research Center survey found 55% of Americans believe immigrants strengthen the country, while 38% think they burden it. In Canada, a late 2023 Abacus data survey shows 47% believe their community needs a fewer immigrants, a 6-point increase from previous months. In Australia, a 2023 Scanlan Foundation survey reveals support for current immigration levels dropped to 52% from 58% in 2022. Former UK Prime Minister David Cameron once said, "Immigration is good for Britain, but it needs to be controlled." This sentiment highlights the need for balanced policies to manage immigration's benefits and challenges. In a globalized world, migration is inevitable. Policymakers must foster integration and understanding to build inclusive societies where both immigrants and native residents can thrive together.